In this video, you will learn how to build intelligent automations. We will extract headlines from the Huffington Post and do some sentiment analysis with them. All of this with Power Automate and Azure from Microsoft. Welcome, RPA champions. I am the RPA champion, and in today's video, we are going to be discovering AI services in Power Automate. Power Automate is known for automating the manual and repetitive tasks that you have on your desktop. But just imagine if you could add AI services to your processes. That would mean that you could automate also cognitive tasks. And that means that you could automate a process from the beginning until the end. Well, with all of that in mind, let's jump into this video and start learning AI services in Power Automate. And we're going to do this with sentiment analysis. I have built a process that I'm going to walk through in just a moment. But before that, I want to make sure that you understand one thing. You should use Power Automate Flow if you really want to do a lot of API integrations for AI services. Power Automate Desktop comes only with these AI APIs that you can use and connect to. Other APIs are not available for Power Automate Desktop to connect to, therefore you cannot use any other AI services apart from the ones that are available right here in the cognitive sections in your actions. So we have Google, IBM, Microsoft. AWS services are missing. They have virtual machines, but they do not have any cognitive services from AWS. That means that if you want to use some machine learning services like Polly from AWS with Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, you cannot, but you can with Microsoft Power Automate Flow. With all of that in mind, let's jump into this process and understand how we use cognitive services in Microsoft Power Automate. In this example, we are going to be doing some sentiment analysis on some text that I will extract from a web page. So to start this process, we are opening the Huffington Post and we are getting the news from this page. So after that, we are going to be extracting the news from this page. Let's add a breakpoint and launch this. This is the page that we are going to be automating, and since I want to show you step by step, we are going to be seeing everything what we do. So let's pause our process right now. Let's actually stop it. Let's extract data from web page. This page, if we go to Google Chrome, we can see what we have. I have created two columns. In one column, we have this that I have done so to extract. I have right-clicked inside of the element and I have selected the text. The same I have done for this. Now I will add this text as well. So let's add this text as well. I will add all of the text. So let's add the first part of the text and let's add the second part of the text. The next thing that we have to do, this is also a list, it's not a table. We have to select the next element that we want Power Automate to identify automatically. And as we can see, it has identified both of the title and the body of the article. Let's rename our columns. One is going to be title and one is going to be body. With that, what we want to do next is we want to set this as the pager. So select this element as a pager. That means that this Power Automate is going to extract all of the elements and is going to click also on next to see the elements on the next page. Let's click finish, and this is what we have right now. Just to go over this, we can extract all of the data. It will go through all of the pages, or we can only select the pages that we want. In this case, I will be using only 5 because we want to extract only 5 from 5 pages, since we are going to be only testing our process right now. Since while we're testing our process, we don't want to extract everything or it will just take too long. Let's save it and let's continue with our process. The next thing that we are doing is we're launching Excel. Why? Because later on we are going to be writing the results inside of an Excel table. So everything that we extract from this page,
Let's go over it one more time. Everything that we extract from here, we are going to be saving it in an Excel file, and we're going to be doing some sentiment analysis on the title. Back to our process. We have to tell Excel where we're going to be writing all of the information. I have an Excel file open. This is what it's going to look like in the end. Let's clean it out. The first cell, this is where we're going to start writing the titles, and this is where we're going to be writing the sentiment analysis score. This is what we have right here. I have chosen the action of get first column from Excel that is available. So you can do that either by typing it here or for looking for it here under the Excel actions. In here, I have just selected the Excel instance that I have opened previously. And in launching an Excel, we have created a blank document. After that, we are going to be doing something pretty interesting. So we're going to be setting a variable, and we're going to take the current item of the loop that we have created. So we're going to create a loop on everything that is extracted from the web page. So this loop, which is a for each loop, and if we go to the loop sections and we select this, we are going to iterate it on all of the elements that are extracted from the web page. That means that we are going to create a loop that is going to go through each one of these titles and each one of these descriptions of titles. That is our loop. Our loop is going to save all of those results in a current item one by one. So the first result is going to be in current item. Then in the next cycle of the loop, the next result is going to be in the current item, and so on. With that, what we are doing right here, we are creating a new variable. We are setting a variable, and we are going to access only the row called, or the column called body. So we're going to just save the content of the body column, and we're going to save it right here. We're going to save it in target. After that, we are finally going to do some sentiment analysis. So to do sentiment analysis is pretty simple. All we have to do is look for the cognitive services and select from the few ones that are available. In this example, we are going to be using sentiment analysis. So we just drag and drop the sentiment analysis and fill out the basic information that is required. The subscription key, and the subscription key, you can get it from Text Analysis API from Microsoft. So in this example, I'm using Microsoft Azure. And I can either go to more info and go on the documentation of Microsoft and understand how it works, or I can also go to the Azure page and I can show you how it's set up. So this is the Microsoft Azure dashboard. What you need to do is search for text analysis, click on this, and create a new instance. So once you have created a new instance, you're going to be able to click inside of it and then go right here into keys and endpoint, select your endpoint or your API key, go back to the Power Automate and put your subscription API. That's pretty much it. The other thing that you have to do is make sure that you select the right region. The right region is also in your documentation. If you go inside of your overview, you can see your documentation right here. With your documentation and your subscription key, that is everything else that you require. The next thing that you have to do is put in the text, and the text is going to be, in our example, some dynamic variable. So in a, not a dynamic variable, it's going to be our target variable right here. So we are going to do something that is going to be like this. Just select our target, and that is going to be the text that we are going to send for sentiment analysis. The language is going to be English, and that's pretty much everything. So I will not save that because I have already created it, and I will also not be opening mine because I have the API key in plain text. So that is how we do sentiment analysis, and that's how pretty much every single one of these services, API services, works. You add a key phrase, you add the element that you want either analyzed, checked out, or downloaded, or processed, or converted, etc., etc. So feel free to check out all of these. I will be making more videos about the other services and some cool use cases. But let's finish this process and see it in action one more time. So once the sentiment is complete, now we're gonna do some interesting stuff. We are gonna write all of this information inside of an Excel file so that we can save it and have it for ourselves. So to write the information inside of an Excel file, we have to select the Excel instance, select the target, which is going to be the title that we are extracting. So we are gonna write the title in column A. Let's review the Excel file. Here we're gonna put the title and here we're gonna put the score. So that is going to be the target and we're gonna put it on a specific cell. Also, we have to select the row. So remember that we've created this get first row on column Excel. So this is going to tell Microsoft Power Automate to always write it in the following row. So with that done for the first row, we have to do something similar for the score. So for the score of the sentiment analysis, we have to create another variable, save this variable and extract the information from the sentiment analysis. What does that mean? Now let's run this process until here and see what happens. So it is opening a new document. It is should start extracting all of the information. It has opened the Excel file. Did we add a breakpoint? Yes, we did. That is excellent. So let's check out the response from the sentiment. So if we go right here and we see that we have the response is right here, but maybe we want a clean response. We want to just get this score. To do something like that, you would usually click on more and you would be redirected to another page. So in this page, we can see right here that we are accessing the variable JSON at documents 0. Now, if we add also score, we can get exactly the score right here. So this is what I am doing right here. I'm creating a variable, I'm calling it target2, and I'm accessing exactly that score. That score right here. I'm accessing exactly that score so that I don't have a messy JSON file. So that's pretty much it. That is our process. The last thing that we do is we write our target2, which is our score, to the Excel file, and we have created a AI process that does sentiment analysis on the titles of the Huffington Post. So that's pretty much it, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope that you have learned something new, and I'm really excited that you are learning more and more about automation. Automation is fundamental. It is becoming a everyday commodity that everybody should know. So stick around for the next video and give yourself a high five. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.